Hey, howdy ho, it's me again, Saturn, and today we will be reviewing the Oceankin Origin, coded by the user Fire Then Ice Gaming from the Origin's Discord. The original concept is by the user The Icebringer Lemur, and this origin is for 1.17, despite it saying otherwise when you first loaded into the world. I'm super excited for this one because it reminds me a lot of Aquaman, and he is one of my favorite heroes, so I'm super excited and super stoked, and I really liked some of the abilities. And I love aquatic-based origins just in general, despite how challenging they can be. But if you happen to catch interest in today's origin, as always, you can download it for yourself in the Origins Discord, which will always be linked below. And with that all done and dusted, let's get on with it. And for our first passive ability, we have Aquatic Body. You can breathe perfectly underwater and your vision is not at all affected by it. And well, this is pretty standard for most aquatic-based origins. It makes sense, you're an origin that is in water and evolved in water, so you can breathe underwater and see perfectly fine. And I'm standing out in front of this ocean monument and I'm doing just fine under here. I can breathe and see in the distance, which is really nice. It's basically just night vision, nothing special going on here. You just have the ability to see underwater, as if you constantly were under a night vision potion. So yeah, that's pretty standard. And that brings us to our next passive ability, which is Tidal Healing, and that gives you the regeneration effect while you are underwater. It's a nice ability that I honestly wish a lot more aquatic origins did include, but unfortunately they don't. It's really nice to see it here on this origin, so yeah. That's pretty much it, not much else to say here. And for our next ability, which is also passive, and you've probably already noticed it on the top right, but that is the Conduit Power, and it is labeled Conduit Heart. You constantly have the Conduit Power that you and nearby players benefit from, and this I wasn't really able to show it affecting another player just because I'm not in any Origin SMPs or I don't really have any friends to join me to test this out at the moment, but I can say that this does work, as the creator did say that this is fully tested, so it should be working just fine. And I just think this is huge. Like, honestly, I haven't seen this on any other aquatic based origin, and I really think it makes it unique because it gives you more of a supportive role to just kind of help your friends out if they're trying to collect ocean resources or just invade ocean monuments. It will be super helpful to have you around. So yeah, I like it, and I hope this starts a trend and we see this more often. And for our last ability, we do have Deity's Respect, which is also passive, and this simply means that Drowned and Guardians bow to you and they are passive. Now, you can see in the background that the Drowned is not paying any attention to me at all, and this is huge. Usually what you see in Origins is that you'll have some ability that makes a certain mob type neutral to you, but I haven't seen one that makes a certain mob type passive. If I hit this Guardian, I do still get hit back because I do think that's like the auto like Thorns ability that they have, but if I'm sniping it here with my title, with my Trident here, it's not coming to beam me at all. It's completely passive. It pretty much respects you as the god of the sea, I guess, and you can just do whatever you want to them and not have to worry about them hurting you at all because they won't. They bow down to you, and I love this. I really want to see more of this in other origins. I don't know why all the other origins are just neutral. If you're like a god or a deity, they should be completely passive to you, not just neutral. And if you don't know the difference already, basically a passive mob means that you can hit them and do whatever you want to them and they will never attack you. But a neutral mob just means that they're neutral towards you, so if you hit them, they will hit you back, or if you provoke them, they will hit you back. So I think this is really cool, and it just adds to the theme of this origin. Very creative, and I do appreciate this a lot. And just to show, this does actually still work on Drowned and not just Guardians. I'm gonna spawn in 3 Drowned here, and they're just ignoring me. They won't do anything to me, and it's not just because they're neutral, as I said before. I can go over here and attack them, and they will not attack back because they're completely passive. And that is just blatantly overpowered in a way. Not overpowered, but it's really cool because Drowned are how you get Tridents, and you can just farm them endlessly with no risk to yourself. And that concludes all of your abilities. They are all passive, and now we will be jumping into your cons, and there's not a lot of them, but they are pretty drastic. And here we are in the Nether. You can see that we have slowness and weakness, and that is because of our con body of water. In the Nether, you begin to evaporate, gaining weakness and slowness and gradually taking damage. And that segments into our next con, and that is lungless. Due to your lack of lungs, you cannot breathe in air. Part of that damage that you saw me take in the Nether was due to the fact that I was suffocating because I did not have any water with me, and that's gonna make it super difficult to do anything in the Nether, but I don't believe it's impossible. I just think that you probably have to be pretty strategic and plan ahead before doing anything, and I like origins like that. It makes you think, and it ultimately makes you a better player. And for our last con, we have Divine Fears. Villagers fearing your divine wrath have began to hate you, and trading prices have increased. So here I have two villagers just chilling here, and as you can see, those prices are slashed, and they did raise them for me. So that is the con, just a little bit more expensive to get the items you want, but it's pretty negligible. And that about wraps things up for the Oceankin Origin. This origin really did take me by surprise with some of its abilities, and I just love the thought that was put into it. It's challenging to play as and requires you to think outside of the box. If I had to change anything about it, it would probably be to give it a slight buff by adding an ability that perhaps gives you a trident when you spawn in. You could even give it a sick name and just make it so it's binded to you, so therefore it is a unique item that only you can possess. And secondly, I would probably add an active ability of some kind. Not to say that the abilities are bad, they're amazing as I stated before. However, having a primary ability is really what makes an origin shine. I'm not sure what ability would be appropriate for this one, but those are just my thoughts. Closing this out, I would just like to say that Fire Then Ice Gaming did an amazing job coding this origin, and the Icebringer Lemur has some amazing ideas surrounding theme and abilities for an origin, especially one like this one. Let me know what you think about today's origin in the comments below, and thank you all so much for watching until the very end, and a bigger thank you to all of you that have subscribed since yesterday's video. I went from 50 to 67 subs now, and it's honestly a little scary. Thank you all so much, I really do appreciate all of the support, and it gives me more inspiration to keep making these videos. It hasn't gone unnoticed at all, but with all of that said and done, I really do hope you enjoyed today's video, and I'll be catching you all in the next one. See ya.